Welcome to our show of Barman Saturdays. In this way, I decided to take a look at a Stork's Journey, which I got in this 4-pack at Walmart. One of these films we've already covered, Alpha and Omega, but that does leave two more to talk about after this one at some point in the future, though I don't think it's going to be this month because I already have picked out another film for the last week. I'm not sure how much I'm going to enjoy that one, though. I haven't watched it yet, so I don't know. It may be horrible, but I guess we should talk about, a Stork's Journey, aka Richard the Stork, aka Little Bird's Big Adventure. I want to say that's one of the other titles. There's quite a few different titles for this film because it had production companies from various countries involved, from like United States, Luxembourg, Germany, which is why some of the wording on the sides of buildings is in foreign languages. Because this is primarily, I want to say, a Luxembourg production, weirdly enough. Because I don't really think of Luxembourg when it comes to animation. Usually it's like United States with Disney or Pixar or, Japanese studios. But we also have to deal with the fact this film has two English dubs, and since I have the later release from Lionsgate, we have their dub, which has, Drake Bell come in to voice the main character, and brings in Jane Lynch to voice Olga, a pygmy owl. So yeah, basically this film is the story of Richard, a sparrow who was adopted by storks at a young age because his parents were murdered before he was hatched by a bear, because, hungry.
Robert!
You chose the wrong day, buddy!
Though I have to question why a bear would climb a statue in order to go after a sparrow's nest. Like, why would you hunt the tiny little sparrows on top of a statue, when there's storks nearby or fish in the river you could snag? Why go after, like, some tiny morsels that, are barely a mouthful, if that, for you? It seems like a lot of effort for very little payoff. Unless it was after the cookie instead, but. And then just took the parents as, a side dish to the cookie. But then only left half the cookie behind. I don't get it. It just seems a bit absurd, the setup for this. It'd be more believable if a predatory bird just came down and grabbed them, before Richard hatched. Why was it a bear? Like, is this just because, bears are iconic, for being villains thanks to stuff like Brave and whatnot, so you gotta have a predatory bear in there instead. But yeah, Richard gets adopted by a stork, much like Tarzan was adopted by gorillas, and comes to see himself, as a stork and likes to imitate them.
I am a stork.
And doesn't believe he's a sparrow for a moment. He's just a tiny stork. Of course, when the other storks decide to migrate south to Africa for the winter, they leave little Richard behind because, he's a sparrow. He's not a migratory bird, so he couldn't possibly make the journey. The winds would just be too strong. So he gets left behind as everyone takes off early in the morning. That had to suck. So when he wakes up and realizes they're leaving him behind, he tries to chase after them, gets blown away by a storm, and crashes into the forest and almost dies on the way down. But along comes Olga to poke him awake and point out the obvious that he's a sparrow. Only for him to tell her that she's weird because she believes in an imaginary friend named Oleg is with her. Or is it Oleg? Yeah, Oleg. Jeez. I don't know. I just think Olga and Oleg sounds better than Olga and Oleg, Just, I don't know. I think this has a better, flow off the tongue. But apparently, her imaginary best friend just will not let her leave tiny little Richard alone, so she decides to help him, find his way south to Africa. And along the way, they meet another character who's very self-centered and tricks them into going into Italy so he can participate in a singing contest, and he doesn't even get to go on the stage and has to cry himself off the sidelines. Then hears about Richard's crazy stunt of trying to jump off a cliff and fly over the ocean, which leads to a very dramatic, near-death sequence.
See you big boys over the rainbow!
I
I'd better use six herring. The green one chomps the first.
Spread your wings!
I can't! No. I can't!
And eventually, you know, Richard finalizing, you know, he's just a tiny little sparrow. But, you know, he has to find out, you know, if his stork family really accepts him or not, so he's still going to Africa anyway. And of course, you know, when he gets there, he finds out his adoptive older, bigger brother, you know, has apparently been kidnapped by a honey badger. So he goes in to save him. And manages to succeed, and he's accepted by the other storks, you know, and everyone gets to live happily ever after, you know, so pretty cliche story, all things considered, I suppose. Though it's well told for the most part, so it's definitely a watchable film, but I wouldn't consider it one of my favorites, not by a long shot. Probably just because I've heard this kind of story before. Though I suppose we can have some, fun screwing around with, this clip.
Here, honey bunny!